Good evening, good morning, good day to you, whoever you are, wherever you are, if you stumble upon this video. We have this 24-hour a day, 7-day-a-week streaming channel that the Creator of the universe led us by His Spirit to make, that people would be aware, that it be brought to the attention of the general public that we are living in the last days. No, it's not just a virus. No, it's a worldwide virus with lockdown. No, it's not just so happened to be locust eating up all the crops in the world. No, it does not so happen to be all these new increased earthquakes, droughts, floods, civil unrest, peace, countries beginning to make peace with Israel in the Middle East. All these things were told to us thousands of years ago in the Bible. Yes, you can hear from God. Anyone can hear from God. God is always speaking, but most people are not listening. It just so happens that you're listening at this moment. You stumble upon this channel. You know, when I first became a Christian, one of the first things I thought of or realized, because I used to love to play all kinds of music all the time, you know, pretty loud. And when I became a Christian and I stopped playing loud music and stuff and stopped watching nonsense on television, I realized, wow, God was there the whole time, but I was so busy keeping my mind busy with television or music or things that people watch on the internet, had it cranked up so loud that I couldn't hear the still, small voice of God saying, no, no, don't go that way. You're on the broad road, the wide superhighway that leads to destruction, as the Lord Jesus Christ said. There's this narrow way. It's not the easy way, but the narrow way. Jesus said it was a narrow way, and straight is the gate, and narrow is the way that leads to life, to heaven. And few are those that find it. And broad is the road, great big superhighway that leads to destruction, and many are going there. And that's why it is such a miracle, it's such a blessing that you happen to be watching this video at this moment out of curiosity. Stumbled upon here because you see all the things going on in the news. These things are not coincidences. All these things have been foretold thousands of years ago, even before Jesus was born. In the Old Testament, 3,500 years ago until 2,000 years ago when the New Testament was written. All these things have been foretold by God through His servants. And today, God still has servants. And we're here to magnify and proclaim those prophecies given by those mighty men of God back in the ancient days to tell you that all these things are happening. One world government is coming through the out of the UN. It will grow and grow to there's a one world government, a one world president or leader or general or king. That will be the Antichrist. One world currency, one world religion. All these things are told in the Bible. All these things will unite for a seven-year period. It says the Antichrist will make an agreement with all those people like in the Middle East, and they will divide the nation of Israel. They'll let the Jewish people rebuild their temple. All those things it's talking about now in the news and in the world. This stuff was written in the Old Testament 3,000 years ago, that there would come a time when all the world would gather together and fight about Jerusalem. There's no oil in Jerusalem. There's no gold. There's none of those things. The only thing in Jerusalem is God said He will fulfill all those Bible prophecies in Jerusalem. Jesus Christ will return back to Jerusalem. So the devil is trying to stop that. That's what all this is about. The devil thinks that he can stop the prophecies of the Bible to be fulfilled, but they're not going to be. God wins. God wins. As a matter of fact, He already won 2,000 years ago. Like right now, for the last 2,000 years, people can be spiritually born again, spiritually delivered, spiritually reconnected with God through one way. The Lord Jesus Christ, He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except by Me. See, when we're born in this world, we're born into sin, like Adam and Eve. God told Adam and Eve, when you eat the fruit, you're going to die. And since the time of Adam until now, until the Lord comes back at the end of the tribulation, everyone is born into sin. Everybody dies. But God made a way for us to be spiritually reconnected back to Him through His only begotten Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. He died on the cross for you and me. He took our sins. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. God told Adam and Eve, and for all of us, when you sin, you're going to die. We've all sinned. and fallen short of God's perfect standard. So none of us are righteous. None of us are in right standing with God. None of us can enter heaven. But we can enter heaven when we have our sin taken away. So what happened is Jesus Christ, God himself, came to earth in the form of a man, lived a perfect life, a sinless life, went to the cross in our place. He died on the cross for you and me. He took upon himself all the sin of the world. And Jesus said that famous verse that everybody knows, John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that who would ever believe in the Lord Jesus Christ would not perish, but have everlasting life, eternal life in heaven." Jesus said that. And he said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can go to the Father except through me," Jesus said. So now is the time. I know you know about Jesus. You know about him dying on the cross. You've seen all that, but you maybe didn't know why. And now you know why. When Jesus was on the cross, you were on his mind. He laid down his life for you and me. And so what we have to do is receive that. That's what becoming a Christian is. The process of becoming a Christian. To be a Christian is to follow Jesus. But the process of becoming a Christian is when I pray and say, "Lord Jesus Christ, I know that I am a sinner. I've told lies." What do you call someone who told a lie? A liar. What do you call someone to take something that doesn't belong to them, even if it's a pencil? When you're a kid, that's a thief. What do you call someone who has relations and lies with a man or a woman that they're not married to? That's an adulterer, a fornicator. Taking the Lord's name in vain, that's a blasphemer. All those things that almost every person on earth has done. From the Ten Commandments. So I say, "Lord, I know I'm a sinner. I know I've fallen short. I know I've told lies. I've done all kinds of stuff. Lord Jesus Christ, I know that I cannot enter heaven based on my own merit. Because according to the Ten Commandments, I'm a liar. I'm a blasphemer. I'm an adulterer. I'm a thief. I'm all those things. A blasphemer of God. I can't enter heaven like that. I'm not perfect. Only perfection can enter heaven." Well, God sent his Son. And so through the forgiveness of my sins can be washed away. They can be removed because God already provided a sacrifice for me. That's why in the Old Testament they sacrificed those animals and all that stuff. It was representing and showing that you have to have, as it says, without the shedding of blood, there's no removal of sins. So that's what it was all about. That's why when John the Baptist, he saw Jesus Christ walking and he said, "Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world." Jesus Christ is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. He is a lion, a roaring lion, but he is also a lamb, an innocent lamb. He's our sacrifice. He's our Passover sacrifice that the angel of death would pass over us. Like in the, you've seen that movie, many of you, Charlton Heston, the Ten Commandments from the Old Testament. When they came out of Egypt, it's called, you know, Passover. They took the blood of a lamb and put it over the doorpost of their house. And when the Lord said, "When I see the blood on the door of your house, I'll make sure that the destroyer, the angel of death, will pass over your house." Brothers and sisters, we need the blood of the lamb over the doorpost of our hearts. Now is the time. Right now. Today is the day. This moment. God said he will not keep asking people. Jesus said, "No one can come to me and follow me unless my Father would draw them." Guess what? Now, it's no coincidences with God. There's no word coincidence in Hebrew. This is your moment. This is your day to get right with God, to become born again Christian, to be a follower of Jesus Christ. Give your life to Jesus Christ because you're not your own. You've been bought with a price. What's that? The precious blood of Jesus washes away your sins. The Bible says, "As far as the east is from the west, so shall your sins be from you." When you've been forgiven, God will throw your sins into the sea of forgetfulness, the Bible says. So this is your moment. This is your hour. This is your day right now to get right with God, to make peace with God, to know that you know that you know that you're on your way to heaven. The Bible says that his Spirit will confirm in your spirit, in your heart, that you are a child of God. I want to pray with you right now. Pray with me. From your heart, not just mimicking what I say. It's what you need to say. "Lord Jesus Christ, I know I'm a sinner. I've done all kinds of things, Lord. I'm unworthy. I'm unworthy to be in your presence. But Lord, I know that you gave your grace. You gave mercy by sending your only Son to die on the cross. Lord Jesus, save me. Lord Jesus, forgive me of my sins. Lord Jesus, I know you died on the cross. I know for my sins. I know you rose again on the third day. I believe and I know that I'm going to go to heaven when I die because you have forgiven me of my sins because I asked you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for you said in your word, if we confess our sins, that you would forgive us and cleanse us of all of our sin. I receive it right now. Thank you for saving me, Lord Jesus. Lord, into thy hands I commit my heart. I commit my life. I commit my future into your hands, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me, for dying on the cross in my place. Thank you, Jesus. If you prayed that prayer with me, you can email me. My email is neartochrist@aol.com. neartochrist@aol.com. You can get in contact with me under this channel. There'll be my email link. And God bless you tonight. And I'll be happy to be here to answer your questions for you. That's what God has preachers for. I'm here to help you. Make sure you got complete understanding and peace of being a Christian. I'm here to help you. God bless.